And everybody should know that's how love goes. It's good for the soul.
Oh, I got a long way to go, but it won't stop the pain. No, no. That's the kind of thing that keeps me coming back again and again.
Till I see your face.
Could mean anything more than this. I don't care if I never speak again.
I can't believe we actually saw a movie at the theater.
That's the way it's supposed to be, babe. Don't worry about babysitters and depending on other folks. The Van Adams plan, do what we want, when we want.
Mwah. Oh, excuse me.
Just work it out.
Hey, Lem, baby.
Lem, baby?
It's Lynette. Just calling to see what's up since you don't know how to call your mama. Listen, I was just wondering.
This is a call from the Cook County Correctional Facility. This phone number and call may be monitored or recorded.
Shit. Look, Lem, they got me locked down on some trumped up mess. Could you bail me out? I'll pay you back.
Come on. I'll see you later, babe. I gotta go take care of this shit.
Okay.
Mm. I'll see you later.
Huh? He's coming back, okay? See you later.
Bye.
Bye, Daddy.
Hello?
Keisha?
No. Who's this?
Oh, can I talk to Keisha?
You can tell me who I'm speaking to.
Ahmad.
Oh.
Hold on. You want to talk to that scrub?
No.
She doesn't want to talk to you.
Well, tell her it's important.
He says it's important.
Not to me.
Not to her.
Tell her I want to apologize.
Wannabe Max says he's sorry. I wouldn't hear it if I were you.
Tell him sorry won't take his lip prints off that Cali girl.
She doesn't want your funky apology.
Would you just tell Keisha to call me?
She's not gonna call you.
Look, why don't you let Keisha speak for herself?
Why don't you speak for yourself?
Okay.
This is getting crazy. Keisha's got two more chances to get it right. And then I'm through.
better now?
Lynette. Look at here.
Hey,
I know this big child ain't my baby. Come to Grandma and Nettie.
Do you mind putting your cigarette out?
Look at that. Look. Is there any oatmeal left or is all of it on your face, huh? Just like your daddy, Lim. You know, he loved him for Quakos. Got them all over his face, too.
Wow, I'd love to see a picture of that.
Hey, baby. I was just telling Bertie.
I heard. What's up?
Brought you your money. Appreciate you bailing me out, baby. You know how it is. That fool JoJo borrowed my car and got tickets on it. They booted the motherfucker. I gave Barnett $20 to take the boot off, and then I get arrested. Believe that shit.
Can you watch your language in front of my son?
Oh, my bad. Some loser looking to make detective locks me up when they got criminals getting away with murder out there.
So all you did was commit a felony, and they hauled you in?
Yeah, you were wrong.
Good thing you didn't leave the details on the machine. I'd have let you spend the night.
After all I did for you.
Oh, especially after all you did for me.
All right, now see, I'm gonna remember that. I'm gonna remember that when I get a call from county.
Oh, it won't be for me.
Heard that before.
You can't talk. What you did was some American stupidest criminal's mess.
Like the time you were a lookout and accidentally locked yourself inside the stove.
When I was 12, you were 28 getting busted for stealing steaks from the store where I worked.
Remember, I'm your mother.
Only when it's convenient.
Let's go get a new diaper, boo.
Come on. Oh, baby. Bertie, let me help you.
The bird's got that, Lynette.
A grandmama can't help change her baby's diaper.
Yeah, Lem, it's okay. She can help.
Okay, I'm going to walk then. See you later, babe.
Bye, sugar.
I was talking to my wife.
Bye, baby.
Bye, baby.
How was your day?
A winch on one of the trucks broke. Of course, the part won't be done until tomorrow, so I was down to one toe today. Of course, the customers don't care about that. They want you there now. No excuses.
I know how that can be. Well, Kelly's teacher called today.
Mm-hmm.
Your daughter got a timeout because she kicked a boy for not giving her his book.
What?
Yep. So now I have a parent conference tomorrow. But don't worry, I'll go after that luncheon I told you about.
Oh, yeah.
You know, speaker without a job, talking to Chicago's most high-powered women about how to win in the workplace.
How's Kenny?
Sleeping.
Well, I wish my biggest worry was talking to a bunch of overachievers and eating salmon tartare. Ahmad, go get your sisters.
Okay.
Just like wondering if I'm making sure Kenny's getting his medication and physical therapy is a worry for you, this is a very big concern for me.
Teri, please. Now you are going to put on one of your expensive suits, use all your big words, and impress everybody in that room.
Maxine, that's not the point.
The point is you need to relax, sis. Miss Keynote Speaker, sit down and eat.
Okay.
Hi.
Hey, hi, babe. We are going to have to have a talk. How's my big girl?
You got it?
Yeah. Good, thank you.
Hi, Sweetum.
Everybody wash their hands?
Yep. Good.
Let's pray. Father, we are thankful.
Did I not hear you call me?
I thought you were asleep.
Well, so you're just gonna eat without me?
I wanted you to sleep, Kenny.
Oh, you want it, huh?
Kenny, Maxine was...
Mind your business, Teri.
You know what, Teri?
Well, please, sit down and eat, baby.
Teri, Max, I am not a child.
Excuse me. I'm going home.
Teri. You need to stop this.
Stop what?
Come on, baby. My sweetheart.
Can I be excused?
Eat your food.
I'm not hungry anymore.
Well, then go.
Usually, my pops is a calm one and my mom's is going off. But now he's tripping, she's not. And if he talks to her like that again, well, I just hope he gets better. Quick.
Get the corner. Just do the pillows.
Hey, babe.
Yeah?
What you think Lynette's up to?
Up to?
Yeah, you know, visit, staying all day, asking me to call her mom.
That's just the way Lynette is. One minute you're the most important thing in her life. Next, you don't see her for a year. I learned a long time ago not to trip off her. Now, what was that for?
I don't know. You look like you need some sleep.
Oh, really?
You know, pillow, sleep.
Well, you need to take a shower.
What? I already took a shower.
Well, I think you missed the spot.
Show me. Where?
Right here.
Teri, hi, great speech. Listen, I was shocked to hear that you left Green Norris. Of course, I would have left too if they didn't make me partner, but with your track record, what were they thinking?
I don't know.
I mean, what really happened?
Will you excuse me?
Thank you. Teri Jones.
Yes.
Carrie Nicholson.
Hi.
Green Norris's new labor law attorney.
Well,
I was hoping we could get together. Maybe grab a cup of coffee. Maybe I could just pick your brain a little. If you're not too busy, I know a wonderful place around the corner where we can...
Actually, I am. I have a doctor's appointment.
Well, what about it?
Sure. Sure.
Here's my business card.
I know the number.
Of course you do.
Thank you.
Hmm. Good news, Miss Joseph. Everything looks normal.
But what about the breathlessness and the heart palpitations?
Yes. Well, you are in perfect physical condition.
Translation, it's all in my head.
No. You're describing what's commonly referred to as panic attacks.
Panic attacks? No, 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 no. I don't have anything to be panicked about. There must be something else.
Right.
No, seriously, Doctor, I'm not the panic type.
Well, neither am I, Ms. Joseph, but I'd like you to take this anyway.
What? Mental Crisis Referral Network?
Yeah. You can go ahead and get dressed and have a good day.
So, Keisha?
Do you hear something?
No, but I smell something.
Can I talk to you?
Anything you have to say to Keisha, you can tell me.
Fine. Can you ask Keisha how come she doesn't want to talk to me anymore?
Can I ask you why you kissed prep girl?
Look, I'm sorry.
I'm over here.
Man, this is stupid. Look, this is getting old. If you want to keep dogging me, that's cool. But I'm not taking it anymore.
Ahmad.
Hey, Allison.
Want to play some 2-on-2?
I'm down.
Directory. I hope you don't mind. Anyway, I'm at work right now, and I'd still love to get together. The number is...
I know the damn number.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm fine.
What can I do for you, Teri?
Well, I went to see the doctor today, and because I'm having these heart palpitations, and my doctor, well, actually, it was the doctor on call, so he's probably wrong, but he gave me this mental health referral card.
My number was on it?
No. I just,
Symptoms?
Lately, I've been, well, the other night, I woke up, and I couldn't breathe. And today, I went to this luncheon. I don't know. Maybe it is the pressure.
You coming in?
To your office?
That's where I usually see patients.
Which I am not.
Well, I just thought you might want to talk about what's bothering you.
Well, there's nothing bothering me.
Okay, Teri, why don't you just come by anyway?
Sure. Let me just check my calendar.
Seabird, our sister's a lawyer and a grocery stocking expert.
I know it. All the kids need to be in the same aisle, and Lem needs to talk to the bread guy.
Why don't you just write him a memo, Teri?
Look, Lem does not need us coming up in there telling him what to do, okay? We agreed to let him do things his way, and his way seems to be working just fine. Mm-hmm.
Just suggestions.
Yeah, well, your suggestions have a way of sounding like orders.
Yeah.
Hello?
Who's that? No, somebody just didn't walk up in here.
I must have left the door open when I was bringing in the groceries.
Hey, where you all at?
Who is that?
Lynette.
Hey, Lynette. I dropped in on Lim at the store. He told me I had just missed you. When he said you did your Sunday dinner shopping, I said not without getting the ingredients for my ass-kicking peach cobbler they didn't.
How you doing, Maxine?
Fine.
So I see. Girl, who do you think you are looking this good after squeezing out 3 babies?
Well, look at you who's talking. You're looking pretty fierce yourself.
I try now. Give me some love, girl.
You succeed.
How you doing, Miss Teri?
I'm fine.
Girl, I love your hair. Who doesn't?
You get one guess.
Bird, is this your work?
Yeah, well, you know I gotta keep my sisters hooked up.
Oh, but you leave your mother-in-law looking raggedy.
Oh, you mean to tell me Bird hasn't had you in her chair yet?
She has locks, Maxine.
Which need to be groomed. And my ends trimmed and conditioned.
Okay, if you need your hair done, you can come in, I'll do it.
Can I come in tomorrow?
Sure.
5 o'clock?
I'll work it out.
Oh, cool! All right. I'll see you guys later.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.
She's so sweet.
Shit. Now, y'all know I told you she was up here yesterday acting like she lived here. Now y'all got me doing her
hair. I was just being
friendly. I wasn't, so whatever just happened, it wasn't my fault. Look, I don't need that woman in my shop. I don't trust her.
Well, what is she gonna do, Bird? Steal your hairdryer?
She might. Shoot, one of my customers told me they saw her hanging out with that Rocco.
Who?
The one who sells stuff out of his car.
Well, surprise, surprise. Van Adams involved in illegal activity.
You stop. That's still Lem's mother.
Whom you don't trust. You are just doing her hair, Bird. You're not inviting her to take over your life.
Thank you.
excuse me.
Terry.
I must have the wrong time.
Nope. No, you don't. You don't.
I thought we were going to do something a little bit more traditional.
Terry, you know I'm not a traditional kind of guy. Well, come on, give it a shot. I think we're good for you.
I don't...
Caldwell. I'm a busy man. I don't appreciate being made to sit while you try to beg someone to stay who's obviously not ready.
How could you possibly know what I'm ready for?
Go on home. You're not ready to sit at the adult table.
Lately, my mom and I have been spending a lot of time together.
Stand, please.
I'm trying to help out as much as I can, especially since my dad came home acting like somebody other than my dad.
Okay, sweetie, I think you can get back to your homework now.
Okay. Hey, Mom.
Mm-hmm.
Did you have calculus when you were in school?
No, only addition and subtraction. And no calculators either. Just an abacus, and only if you were rich. Of course we had calculus.
What is this?
The bills, Kenny. I'm paying them.
Max, I told you, I'm taking over again.
I don't remember you saying that.
Well, I did. Now, look, I can do this. I got a system. You know, it's probably all screwed up by now.
Oh, I messed up your system?
Maybe.
What is your system, Ken?
Well, you know, I'm not explaining my system to you. I mean, you probably wouldn't get it anyway. Oh, come home. Maxine, you're paying Marshall Fields the minimum? I mean, go ahead and double it. I'm not paying all this interest.
Kenny, why don't you just go ahead and write the check your damn self? I mean, I've been doing it since the accident, but I probably don't know how to do that either. Oh, Dad! Sweetie,
don't touch me. Just don't touch me. But give me that cane.
This definitely is not my dad. And whoever he is going to get jacked if he treats my mom like that again.
Ahmad, go back to your homework, honey. Go ahead.
She's the best stylist in town, next to me.
I heard that.
Girl, you are doing it up in here, honey.
Try. So what are we going to do today?
Whatever you want to, sugar. As long as it includes everything you can do.
Everything I can do, huh? Let me get you an ashtray. Here you go.
You know, I'm thinking you might want to touch up the color on my roots.
Oh, yeah, I might want to do that, huh? You are good, you know that?
No, you're good. Oh, girl, you have hooked your mother-in-law up. Hey, you know what? You're gonna have to let me take you out as payment.
But I prefer money as payment.
Girl, you know it ain't right to charge family. So we going out or not?
Let me call Lem and see what he wants to do, okay?
Mm-hmm, go ahead, call him.
Ever since I was 10, I wanted to be Picasso. I'd take charcoal outside and draw on the driveway. I was always sketching. My mother used to have fits because I'd come in for dinner with my hands stained black from constant drawing. My father... Well, teachers used to encourage my talent, and my father told them not to distract me, that his only son was going to be a doctor. See, he had a plan for me, and it didn't involve art.
And your plan?
Become the doctor my father wanted me to be.
How do you feel about that?
Well, inside, I'm still an artist.
So, anyone else want to share? Terry, how about it?
How about you not put me on the spot?
Well, let me help you out.
You were a homecoming queen, your high school's most likely to everything. You got a scholarship to college where you continued to compensate for your beauty by studying hard and being the top of your class. And now you have to decide between the two gold mines who want to marry you. Pick the bigger diamond and stop wasting our time.
Technically, this is my time as well. So if I wanted to waste it, that would be my prerogative.
Teri, I'm going to ask you to forget about Casey's insult, okay? And just share anything that's on your mind.
Well, you know, I'm better at keeping things in than letting things out. And I have been a little overwhelmed lately. I left a good job that should have been better. My sister is running her husband's company and trying to raise three kids, and my other sister is married to an ex-con whose mother is driving her crazy, and I want to say, you married an ex-con. What did you expect?
But I have to find a way to be supportive, you know, helpful, without being resentful.
Did you ever get the feeling your family had a secret meeting, took a vote, and decided you'd be the one to carry all their stress?
Yes. But, you know, they are your family. So, what are you supposed to do if they need you?
What do you need?
I need a little bit of me. For me.
Just one?
Hey, toast! To my son and my daughter, who gave me a beautiful grandson. He is a family, right?
It's a family.
Hey!
Everybody make some noise! We got more Dave Austin!
Now, this song is hot.
That's the cut, baby. That's the cut. Come on. Come on, girl.
This song goes out to all the women in the club tonight. Let me see you with your hands and your glasses in the air. You'll see. That's her, baby.
You're the kind of girl every brother wants and needs in their life. Yeah. No matter what the situation is, you stand by me. Whether I'm
she'll be fine. She always is.
Maybe she was just having some fun.
Well, I don't want to watch my mother dry hump some stranger.
What are you doing up so late?
Heard a noise.
Oh, it's the adding machine. Sorry, I couldn't sleep.
I know. That's why Mom didn't want to wake you for dinner the other night. She wanted you to rest.
Mm-hmm. Well, go to bed now. Say goodnight, son.
What's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
I mean, what's really wrong besides the accident? Why you treat Mom so bad and snapping at her and stuff?
You know, Ahmad, stop yourself.
I mean, you yell at her about stuff that's not even her fault.
You're about to be real disrespectful, boy.
You told me never to let anyone disrespect my mother. But you never told me what to do if the person disrespecting her was you.
Go back to bed, Ahmad. Now.
There are no new messages in your mailbox.
Are you gonna talk to me, or are you gonna sit there and grumble? This is some bullshit all night.
I ain't got nothing to say. Besides, this ain't got nothing to do with you.
Lem, you overreacted.
But we at the same club. Lynette dropped us for some freak.
Lynette is grown. Besides, she's your mother, not your girlfriend. You're acting like some kind of jealous boyfriend.
Hey, Lem, tell your mom I'm next. See ya.
Jealous boyfriend.
Now take it behind outside. Don't you come back in here until them street lights come on.
Go ahead.
Lem, did you hear what I said?
Lem.
What?
Did you hear what I said?
I'm sorry, Lynette got me tripping. Let's just go to bed.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, baby. How'd you sleep?
All right. How about you? You okay?
I'm fine.
You sure?
I'm sure. Why?
Because you've been acting funny.
I'm acting funny?
Yeah. Dad's acting like a jerk and you're letting him. And when I tried to talk to him about it, he pretended like nothing was happening, just like you're doing now.
Ahmad, your dad's not back to his old self yet. And I'm not letting him get away with anything. I'm giving him space.
Space for what?
Space to hurt.
Well, I don't like how he's treating you. And I'm not putting up with it anymore.
Hey, 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 hey. This is not your problem. You hear me?
Your daddy is having a very hard time adjusting. And sometimes, when people hurt, they feel like the only thing that can ease their pain is to lash out. They don't mean it. They just need someone to let it out on. Me and your dad, we got this. All right?
All right. Hey, Mom.
Hmm?
Do girls do that, too? Lash out at you because they're mad?
Anybody can do it, Ahmad. Even Keisha.
What? And please, I wasn't even thinking about her.
Oh, no.
Now, the day I left for college, my sister decided to steal me a blender to take with me. She got busted. My parents ended up having to go bail her out, and I took a taxi to the airport. I worked so hard for that scholarship, and there was no one there to say good luck, goodbye, nothing.
Thank you. Anyone else want to share? Teri?
Took me weeks to tell my sisters that I didn't make partner. Weeks.
Why?
Because I was afraid that they'd think I'd failed.
And did you fail?
Still trying to figure that one out.
You missed the Van Adams. Leave us your info.
Hey, y'all. Lynette here. I can't believe you left. I had me a good time anyway. Birdie, I sweated out all them crimps you hooked up for me, girl. Bet Lem pouted the whole way home. You really need to grow up, boy.
What?
Yeah, when you work your shit. Oops. Sorry, Jay. When you get over your little move, call me.
Ladies, yourselves. Thank you so much for calling me back. I really appreciate it.
Don't worry about it.
No worries.
This is going to sound so stupid, but I saw your photo in an old Green Norris directory, and you are just so much prettier in person. I mean, not that the picture was bad or anything, but you know how sometimes people take pictures and can't really see them.
Listen, I know you're probably looking for a mentor or a friend. But unfortunately, I can't be either right now. I'm still meeting with you because I feel that I should, but... You know, if you have any specific questions, you should just ask me.
Gladly.
Great.
I'm damn good at what I do. My credentials are ridiculously impressive and I'm quite ambitious. But even as you know, no one makes it to the top on talent alone.
Your point?
I need your help. What's the best way for me to play this situation?
What situation?
Green Norris. Who do I work to get that corner office and partner on my letterhead?
Oh. I can't help you there. You see, Keri, I didn't work anyone. I was just the best lawyer I could be.
And look how well that worked out for you, huh? I guess all I want to know is... What would you do differently if you could?
Nothing. Not a thing.
What are you doing here?
I was walking by.
cool. I'm glad you came by. I need to tell you something.
I didn't even come by. I was walking by.
Yeah, whatever. Look, my mom says you're lashing out at me because you're hurting. And I'm supposed to give you time to do that. So, I'm gonna do that. Give you time.
I don't want time. I want to get back together. But I have some rules. One, no more kissing any girls.
Except you.
Except me. Two, no more lying.
Okay.
And three, no more Reggie.
Whoa, hold up. Reggie's my boy.
Okay. You're my boyfriend again. Let's kiss.
Cool. Oh, the house. Let's do it over here.
Ow! Ow! Expecting someone?
Jay, come to Grandmama Nettie.
He's fine.
How you doing, Bertie?
I'm wonderful. Good. What brings you out our way?
4 free tickets to Kitty World. They fell into my lap, and all we have to do is get there.
Oh.
We can, just fill up your tank and make it a family trip.
I don't think so. They're probably hot.
Lem, I am making an effort. And while you are sitting here with that frown on your face, acting like the world is coming to an end, I am trying to work it out. Can you help me out here, Bertie?
Well, baby, actually, it does sound like a good idea. I mean, Jay's never been anywhere like this. We've been talking about it for a while. I could juggle some appointments at work. We can make a weekend of it.
My assistant manager is more than ready to handle the store alone. Breathing down my neck about it, too. Just itching for the shop.
Now, come on, baby. You know you want to hang with your mama.
All right.
We're going to Kitty World, say Kitty World.
Rescheduling isn't the problem, Shirley. Rescheduling 7 times in a 2-week period is. I can't help you that way. Okay. Bye-bye. Come in. Teri.
Hi.
Hope isn't another hour.
I know. I'm not coming back to group, so I thought I should tell you in person.
Thank you. Do you want to sit down?
Yeah.
What's up?
I'm not like those people. You know, I don't have anything to figure out, and I don't have to come to terms with anything. I already knew that I needed more time for myself. And I already know that there's nothing that I would have done differently at Green Doors. And I love my family. And I accept my position in it.
Why are you having panic attacks?
Trouble breathing. That's all it is. It's trouble breathing. And it's gone.
Okay. Sounds good. Take care of yourself, okay?
You do the same.
See you again soon.
No, Dr. Caldwell. You won't.
Thanks. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Baby, did you pack those t-shirts?
Check.
What about a blanket? I don't need my child to freeze.
I don't want my son freezing either, Bert.
I know. I'm sorry. Mwah.
It's okay. Jay's packed.
I'm just excited.
Hey.
Hey.
You're early.
Yeah.
And a little overdressed for a 5-hour car trip.
There's a little change of plans. Once in a lifetime opportunity. JoJo got Macy Gray tickets and he wants us to make a weekend of it. So I was just wondering if maybe we could do Kitty World some other time.
Hell no.
That's all right, baby. Listen, I can go right back out there and tell JoJo that I've already made other plans.
No. You want to go with the guy that got you thrown in jail? Go ahead. But next time, it won't be my money that gets you out.
You know, I'm about tired of you and your little tantrums.
And I'm tired of your bullshit.
You watch your mouth. I done already told you that I am still your mother.
My mother? What kind of mother beats a 6-year-old with a belt because he spilled her weed? Or leaves him in the car for hours while she's at the Norwood getting drunk? But you know what? I'm the stupid one. Because you ain't never changing. I got a new plan. Stay the fuck out of my life.
Bird, you want to help me out here?
I would love to, Lynette, but I gotta go unpack.
No, you don't. We're going. Lynette, you and JoJo have fun at your concert. I'm taking my family to Kitty World.
He'll get over it.
I hope he doesn't. Goodbye, Lynette.
Husband has been an asshole lately, and he's asking you to forgive him.
I got it.
Okay. You know, going from man of the house taking care of your family to being helpless. I just don't feel like I've been a man at all. You know, I know I've said some horrible things. Worst of all, I let my son see me treat his mother wrong. Now, I know an apology can't undo my wrongs.
But it makes it better. And you are a man, Kenny. The perfect man, my man. In 101 ways that have nothing to do with whether or not you bring home the paycheck.
I love you.
I love you more.
Son.
I cooked.
I see. That looks good.
You know, I was getting a little lightheaded standing over the stove, and my son told me, you know, go sit down. I'll handle it.
Well, thank you, Ma.
You're welcome.
And thank you, baby.
everything I knew. Life's been torn apart. Home is just a song.